Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today on Cooking Up Love, I am sharing one of the most used recipes from our family cookbook, our Aunt Celestia's authentic Mexican rice recipe. It's light, it's fluffy, and it is so flavorful. This rice is perfect for any time you're serving up Mexican food, and it makes a decent amount, so there will be plenty of leftovers. It's so delicious. One of my favorite ways to eat it is right out of the fridge. Here's the ingredients I'm using, and I've listed them all in the description box below for you. To get started, peel and chop 2 garlic cloves. Then peel and chop 1 medium onion. If this is your first time at our channel, we'll show you how to make delicious dishes that you can proudly share with everyone that you love. And I'd love to have you join us every week when we share new recipes. Subscribe to find out when we've posted the next one. Next, measure out 1.5 cups of rice and give it a good rinse. Shake off as much water as you can, and if you have extra time, you can set it aside to dry more thoroughly. But I'm usually trying to get dinner on the table and just shake off as much as I can. In a large skillet, heat 1/3 cup of oil over medium heat. I'm using avocado oil. You can use whatever oil you have on hand. Olive oil or vegetable oil, and once the oil is hot, add the rice. Stir it around so that all the rice grains get coated with the oil. And we're gonna fry the rice for about 8 to 10 minutes until it turns a light golden brown color. During that time, keep stirring the rice every so often so that it cooks evenly. Once the rice has this light golden color and smells a little nutty, add the onion and the garlic, and cook that for a couple of minutes until the onion is soft and translucent. Then add in 1 can of tomatoes, undrained, and I like to use the chopped fire-roasted tomatoes. You can use what you have. Stir it around and cook this for about 8 to 10 minutes until the mixture is almost completely dry, and you'll want to stir it often so that it doesn't brown too much on the bottom. Next, sprinkle in 1 teaspoon of salt and give it a stir, and then carefully pour in 4 cups of chicken broth. Then reduce the heat to medium, and we're gonna let this cook all by itself for about 20 to 30 minutes until most of the liquid has been absorbed. You'll start to see holes start to pop up on the top once it comes towards the end of that cooking time, and then you'll know that the rice is almost done. I like to take a spoon and push some of the rice around just to see how much liquid is left on the bottom, and then continue cooking it until it's all evaporated, like this. Okay, for the final step, just remove the pan from heat, and I just turn off the burner, and then cover it with foil or a lid and set it aside for 10 minutes. That's so that the rice can soften. Then just fluff it with a fork or a big spoon and enjoy. You can serve this rice with your favorite tacos, like these. Just click here for that recipe. Or with carnitas or enchiladas, or you can use it to make delicious burrito bowls or stuffed peppers. If you like this recipe, consider sharing our channel with a friend. And if you love good homemade Tex-Mex, check out our recipe for steak fajitas with a creamy poblano mushroom sauce. They are definitely not your average fajitas, and I think you're really gonna love them. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I'll see you in the next video.